Yes. So, dear students, having seen how to formulate the problem and what are the various steps that you need to follow to formulate a problem that is solvable by artificial intelligence, and we have seen many problems, maybe a toy problems as well as some real world problem, and how to frame it using the problem. And now today what we are going to see is how to search solution for the problem in order to create artificial intelligence. So with regard to artificial intelligence, the solution is treated as a action sequence. So it is not a single sequence, it has n number of sequences, and your algorithm should choose any one sequence from the available set of sequences as a best possible solution to represent the problem. So in that case, what you need is you need to have some data structure that supports the solution generation. So whenever you go for searching in the data structure subject, if you could remember that there are two types of data structure. One is linear as well as the non-linear. The linear data structure deals with the linear arrangement of data, whereas the non-linear data structure deals with some non-linear arrangement of data that is treated as a hierarchical arrangement as well as geographical kind of arrangements. So for hierarchical arrangements you have tree, and for geographical or topographical kind of arrangements you have a graph. So first of all, let me discuss about the tree data structure in which the solution space has been generated as a tree. Maybe it is created as an expanded one, or it is created as a generated one, and accordingly you will find a solution to that. So what is the thing that is needed here is when you are generating the tree based on the problem, let me take the problem here as a kind of problem that is a traveling salesman problem. When you look at the picture here, when you look at the picture here, yeah, yes, this. So you treat this as a source node. You treat this the first node as a source node, and this node might be treated as a destination. So to reach this destination node, you may find many paths. One sequence is coming this side, and go this side. And another is going this side, this side, this side. So there are n number of sequences are possible in order to reach a particular location from a source location. But all these sequences has to be generated as a tree like this, tree like this. That is, this is the initial one. This is the source city. From the source city where the route has been expanded, it has been expanded via this city or that city or that city. If you choose this city, then what are the other possible ways? Likewise, for every point of contact, you will have n number of solutions to reach the destination. And it is just to be decided accordingly based on the credit value, or based on the weight factor, and based on the some kind of some kind of element that is required to guide the search process, searching process. You may heard about, whenever you start reading about the tree structure, you may have a leaf node, parent node, root node. So those kind of steps are available here. And one more important thing is important thing that you need to remember with respect to AI is frontier. So what is mean by frontier? The set of all tree nodes available for extension at the end. So that is called frontier, or it is otherwise called as open list. That is, when you look at this example, so this is a node. What are the frontiers for this node? This is CBU, Timișoara, and Serind. So because these are the node which is present in the front side of the particular node, and you have to choose any one of the node for that expansion. So that is the idea here, frontier. What is the search strategy? So the search strategy is you need to choose. So in what way you are going to do the search strategy? There are many search strategies available. So once you have defined a tree, you know that tree traversal, inner traversal, posterior traversal, that is not meant for a traversal purpose. But what about for searching? Searching, you also heard about the term, two terms like breadth first and depth first. And apart from those search techniques, here you have uniform search and some other searching. So those are the topics that we are going to discuss it in this class. So whenever you draw a tree structure, you may have heard about different kind of terms with respect to AI. One is a repeated state or loopy path. So by the name itself, we can say that some particular state, because in the yesterday class we have told about we have discussed about the different kinds of states that are available. So when I repeated the state, so that is the state can be possible whenever you choose a particular sequence, that in that particular sequence, if the particular state is keep on repeatedly coming, means that is a, so that means the path is loopy. So you are circling towards one particular loop, and it may go up to infinite, or it may go up to endless solutions. So that is the situation here. Or otherwise, you may see that the paths might be sometimes redundant. The paths might be sometimes redundant. The paths are redundant paths also there. So that is the case with respect to general strategy for searching the solution. So let me go into a particular topic of thing. So I already told that there are two kinds of non-linear data structures. One is a tree. In tree, how to do the search? In graph, how to do the search? So everything is same. If the tree is empty, then you have to return. If it is not written, then you have to initialize the frontier. What is the frontier? Set up the leaf nodes in there. So then you need to inside the loop, you have to check. If the frontier is empty, then return failure. So if there are no more frontiers available, then no more exploration is possible. If the frontier is present, then you have to explore further and further, you have to find the sequence until it reaches the destination, and you have to count the total weight values along the path of the search. And that path will be, you have to take into consideration whether it will be a minimal one or maximal one, or it is an optimal one. So accordingly, you have to choose this. So like this, the steps are very simple. If the node contains a goal state, then return the goal state. So if it is a goal, that means if it is a destination node that is to be explored. Otherwise, what you have to do, you have to add the node to the explore state, and then you start exploring the further frontiers in that particular node. So that's what the searching is all about, concerned when you are going to search the data in their particular data structure. While you are doing so, you can also form a kind of a grid. So that is the grid that is shown here. So the grid also you can form, like a grid also you can form. So from here I have gone there, I have gone there, I have gone there, I have, like that, like a grid also you can represent. The separation property of graph search is illustrated on a rectangle grid proxy, so you can represent it with a grid also. So what is this? The white nodes are always a separate export region. So that is the white nodes will be useful to separate the region from the unexplored node to explored node, whereas the black nodes will remain the state space of the region. So in that way, you have to represent the portion as a rectangular grid, and you can find. See, this is the general graph. That is actual data is blueprinted in the form of a trace, and then over the trace you can find a lot of sequences, but it is a two-dimensional view of that location, that is a general graph, and it is viewed as a rectangular grid. So that is the difference. So what are the infrastructure that are required for any general search algorithms? You need some kind of state. You need what are the parents, you need what action you have to do, you need to calculate the cost, path cost, that is you know, the Dijkstra algorithm, minimal spanning tree, those kind of stuff. So path cost you need to take. So state is initially what state it is having. At that stage, what is its parents, is it having any frontier or not? If it is having frontier, what action has to be taken? And if you take a particular action along the trace, so what is the path cost associated with this? Everything you need to discuss about it. So when you are going to develop or when you are going to design any search algorithm, then the infrastructure for the search algorithm should be these main four components: state, parent, action, path cost. So this is the node. This is the node. Right now you are here. That is this, in this state you are here, 5, 4, 6, 1. So whatever is the thing you need to do, if you look at it, you have to move this 4 right side, then 5 right side, 6 upward, then 1 left side. This is one state, and what is your goal? You have to bring this one here. You have to bring this one here, or you can move these 4 here, and you move upward 1 here. Then you have to move like that. You need to change a position of the node. So accordingly, you need to take what is the action you have taken, what is the total cost that are involved, what is its parent, that is what is the previous state. Because sometimes you need to do backtrack. Suppose if you are trying to do a solution, produce a solution by following one particular sequence. So in case while following that sequence, if you feel that that track is not workable and you want to come back, means then you need to remember the parent. Then only you can come back. Otherwise, you don't know where to go, where to come, and you will be in the deadlock situation. So that's the thing needed. So whenever you need to do a search algorithm for any particular generation of action sequence, you need these four components: state, parent, action, podcast. When you take the child node, what is a child node? Whenever you want to create a node, that is, whenever you want to span a new sequence in the already existing sequences, that means you are going to create a new node. So that node should also be associated with what is the state and what is the result of that node, what is the parent of the node, and what action you have taken, and what is the podcast. Podcast means previous cast plus the cast to reach that particular child node. So that should be recorded with respect to every child node that you are going to span while generating the action sequence. When you are going to represent this kind of data structure, then it is very easier for you to use a queue data structure. You all very well know that a queue data structure will be having a style called FIFO queue. In case if you are going for a stack, then it is called as LIFO queue. You may also use a priority queue with the kind of priority you can use. So in general, queue is been very useful data structure for that. And what are the methods associated with the queue? Whether the queue is empty or not, pop the element from the queue, insert the element into the queue. So these are the some popular operations associated with the queue that you know it very well. Whenever you design an algorithm, then it is important to provide the details of performance, how that algorithm is working, how that algorithm is performing. So for which, what are the things that are required is completeness, optimality, time complexity, spacing. These are the things that you need. Completeness means whether the algorithm is complete enough to provide the solution or not. Optimality means whether the solution provided by that particular algorithm will be a one which is the best suited for the problem. That is best optimal. That is, if it is a minimum solution you are expecting, then it should be the minimum element. If it is maximum element that you are expecting, then it should be the maximum element. Likewise, you, what is the time complexity that you have done? You know how much time it is required and how much space is required. Accordingly, you have to defend the problem performance. Other steps are very easier. Then you can go and refer while reading the book for this. So what are the search strategies available? So the first kind of search strategy that we are going to discuss is uninformed search strategy. The uninformed search strategy may be treated as a blind search. As against uninformed search, there is another search, that is informed search strategy. Otherwise, it is called as heuristic search. So under the heading uninformed search strategy, so why it is called uninformed search strategy? Because it doesn't need any additional information. So it is going to search for the element according to certain rules. According to that rule, it is going to search the elements. So what are the search techniques available? That is a breadth first search. That you are very much familiar. So this is the pseudocode for the breadth first search in terms of A. But nothing new in it, but in terms of A, it is a breadth first search. And what is the other kind of search? Uniform search, uniform cost search. The uniform cost search is nothing but a priority queue based search. Then a depth first search. So these are the three search techniques under uninformed technique, and followed by the one as a depth limited search and a iterative deepening depth first search. So that is the idea that is discussed here. And a bidirectional search. And so what are the search techniques available? Breadth first, uniform cost, depth first, depth limited, iterative deepening, bidirectional. For all the cases, you have the performance metrics for completeness, time, space, optimality. So for what the kind of search you need, you have got the optimal solution. Breadth first, iterative deepening, bidirectional. So what is this A and what is this B and what is this C? You can refer the footnote. So totally how many search techniques we are going to deal with? So we are going to study about six search strategy in this particular situation, right? Discuss these topics in a separate lecture in order to record the lecture in a separate topic. So until then, we will close for the today's session. So what is the topic that we have discussed today is, we have formulated the problem in the yesterday topic of discussion. In this topic, what we have discussed is how to develop the solution for that. So how to develop the solution for that, it should be a sequence. It should be an action sequence. And the active sequence should be represented as a stretch search tree, and the search tree should be represented like a tree data structure. And that tree data structure, you have to do search, maybe a graph or a tree. You have to do a search. There are many algorithms are available, and you need to follow certain terminologies. And what are the performance metrics that have to be associated with searching the action sequence? That is K-tip and action podcast. So with this, we will close the discussion of generating the solution. Maybe in the next class, we will discuss deeply about uninformed search strategies.